Hello, this is an Astroneer tutorial on a resource counter and display. So the display in the background right now is currently going up as we put more resin on our storage system. The system is counting the individual resources that are being put in the system and displaying it on the 4-digit screen behind me. This screen can technically go up to 9,999. But since we're only loading 3 canisters, it's gonna fill up around the 1200 mark. We can also come over here and press this button and reverse the direction, thus taking resources out of our storage system, and the displayed number of resources that we have starts going down. So let's change it today and see how this works. So let's start with the display first. For each large active storage that is displaying a number, we have a setup of a segment, 7-segment display. I have another video on this and went over how to set this up, but basically we're duplicating that 4 times for each of the numbers. We have input from our number storage over here that basically comes over here and selects the specific number that we want to display. You can see that here we have 992, and basically 992 is selected on the panel behind here. For the actual input counter, what we have is we have a storage sensor going into 2 power switches, which is flipping these back and forth, and a button repeater, which is toggling both the auto arms and this set of power switches. So what this does is when it is depositing resources, this power switch is on and this is being toggled back and forth. So this power sensor is sending that signal into our addition line, which is over there and we'll get to in a sec. And when we are pulling resources out of the system, this power switch is on, which allows the storage sensor over here to trigger this power switch, which gives you a power sensor output to our minus line over here. So now on to the heart of the system. This is our number storage device. This actually stores the number that is right now 992. It can store up to 9,999. This particular device is not in binary, it's in base 10. So if you look here, it's segmented into 4 different sections. We have the first section, which is just our numbers 0 through 9. We have the tens place, which is 0 through 9 in the tens digits. We have the hundreds digits and the thousands place. So each of these are pretty much exactly the same as the other ones. And they're all for displaying a number 1 through 9. What we have is for each output here, this indicates the number that we want to display. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and down the line. And all the segments are identical. First, let's go into what a segment is, and then I'll explain the whole system, how it works. What we do is we have the power switch, which is telling us what number is actually active. In this case, it's 2, because we have 0, 1, 2. It comes into this platform. This platform is connected to both these power switches, and the power switches are connected to a power sensor set to power gained. We also have a power sensor coming out of here that is also on gained or lost, and this is to, when the number is selected, we want to trigger that particular number on our number display, and when it is deselected, which is why this is on gained or lost, we want to deselect that number from what we're displaying and select the next number that we're displaying. So how addition and subtraction works in this is you have an input over here where we're going to say we want to either add, which is this line, or subtract, which is this line. It is going into a button repeater and a delay repeater set to one tick. So when you hit this button once, you get a pulse through here that is going to turn on and off our power switches. It comes over to this central location, which is split between these two button repeaters, just so we have enough lines to select everything. And basically, if you follow this button repeater, you can see that it goes to all of the top power switches on this side. There's five, and there's another button repeater on the other side, which goes to the remaining five. This only goes to the top power switches on the platforms, and that indicates that it's the plus circuit. If I select this one, you can see the glowing lines are on, let's see, where is it? There we go. So this is the minus circuit. It's going to the bottom power switches. And basically how this works is whenever you hit the addition switch, it's going to toggle every single one of the top power switches on here. And if you get an output from the power sensor flips to the next power switch, which indicates your number. So in this case, it's if for the one, because there's no power coming into it, we're going to toggle this switch to add, and we're not going to get an output, so it's not going to do anything. But for this switch, if we toggle the add, it is going to give power to this, which is swapping between this power switch and this power switch. So it turns this power switch off and turns that power switch on. This allows you to go up the line. So, you know, this if we got an add, then this power switch would be on, and it would only swap between this on power switch and this power switch when we get a signal through here. The same thing happens with the minus. So we toggle every single minus power switch when we toggle the minus line, and that swaps the power switches going downward. So if we were to toggle the minus line on here, it would toggle this power switch on and off, which would give us a signal through this power switch, which, if you can see here, would flip this power switch off and turn this power switch on. So each of these lines is identical with a power switch indicating your number, the add power switch, the minus power switch, the power sensors going through those power switches, and finally the power sensor, which is set to gained or lost, which gives you the output for your actual number. With setting up 10 of those, so you have the numbers 0 through 9, you can basically count up and down between 0 and 9. The special thing is when you get to the end. So on the end, this is the 9 sensor, but there's no tens place. What this does is if you add 1 when you have a 9, it goes through this line, which turns off the 9 switch. It comes back around here and turns on the 0 switch, but it also sends a signal up through to the next digit. So in this case, you get 0 through 9, and then at 9, this goes back to 0, but this goes from 0 to 1. So using that logic, it's exactly the same for all four sections, and basically it increments from 0 to 9 and then bumps this up by 1, and then once this goes from gets to 99, this will, you know, the 9 will bump down to 0. It'll send a signal along. The 9 here will bump this down to 0 and send a signal along, and you'll go from 0 to 1 on here. So that is how you create a resource counter that goes from 0 to 9,999 using a ridiculous amount of power switches, power sensors, and a lot of other stuff. If you have any questions, please comment below and I'll try to answer any questions about this design. I know it's very complicated and hopefully I've done a good job explaining it. If you like the video, please subscribe and thanks for watching.